What is up, killers? Kev here, and today back with a brand new episode of 5 New Console Mods to hit the Bethesda.net website this week. This is going to be episode 422 within my series, but without further ado, guys, let's just jump straight into the video. Now, this is going to be an absolute banger for the PlayStation 4 users. I'm a little bit jealous that it's not on any other platform, aka the Xbox One. For this one, it is going to be weapons, a block, arrows, and magic. Now, if you want to feel like a true swordsman within the game and you're on PlayStation 4, you're going to have to get this mod. This one is coming in only 1.1 kilobytes of download. This mod applies and deflects arrows, an elemental projection perk, when using the block with just a weapon, allowing you to block arrows and magic without a shield. The stroke of your sword, they shall be gone. The original for this one is going to be on the PC, but we're not playing the PC, we are playing the console. So if you want to grab this one in your PlayStation 4, definitely grab this one. It is really cool and really fun to play with. Now, you guys know I love a silly mod every now and then, and I do love including them within this series just so we can get a little bit more exposure, a little bit more joy out of the game too. This is definitely going to be one. Now, the mod authors said within the description this is going to be a joke, so please do not get your pants in a twist. For this one, it is going to be called The Dragonborn Dies, coming in at 67.8 kilobytes of a download. The Dragonborn arrives in Helgen and is beheaded immediately, thus ending the adventure very quickly. And that's it. You pretty much go back to the base screen, which is absolutely hilarious. A lot of people are loving this one too. They really do like it. They're finding it funny. A lot of people saying finally, you know, something incredibly like this. The executioner is going to be pretty quick on that one. He's not going to be waiting around for no dragon. He is going to just slam your head off. And with that one, it's a little bit more immersive, a little bit more real to the game. Beast hair, horns and beard, vanilla-based replacer. This one is coming in a baffling 802.8 kilobytes of a download. But this one is a standalone mod ported from the NexusMods.com, being vanilla-based using assets from other mods such as Khajiit hair and additions to hair for male and female, adds 8 different types of hair for female Khajiits and only 6 for males. This one is really cool indeed. Now, I'm running a load of other different mods, so you're probably going to see any of the difference too, but if you're running a vanilla based game and you want something just to make your sort of Khajiit a little bit more intimidating, a little bit more terrifying, a little bit more immersive, maybe a little bit more bulkier to that sort of class that you're playing or something like that, this is definitely going to be a mod to grab. Loads of people have been enjoying this one, and personally, I really am enjoying the Khajiit race once again. But the penultimate spot within the video is going to be Smooth Sky Mesh by Jaws. This one is going to be a port from the NexusMods.com. This one is coming in at 14.6 kilobytes of a download. Makes the transition between the sky sections a little bit more smoother. From sunset to sunrise, the seams are going to be fixed, the sharpness in the sky is going to be a little bit more crispier, and the reduce of color bounding or binding between the two sort of run into each other, not sort of two set solid colors sort of merging together like you would your hands. Kind of imagine a candle dripping into each other with different colors. I don't know where I'm going with this, but guys, it's absolutely great. For someone who sort of is taking a fair few sort of landscape pictures with their time off from making videos, this one is going to be an absolutely great one. If you do like sort of looking into the sun, maybe you're on the top of a tall mountain and you just want to see the world go by when the sun comes up or goes down, this one is definitely going to be a banger to grab. And for the penultimate spot within the video is going to be The Thorn, coming in at 6.5 megabytes of a download. Craftable blade of woe, inspired poison blade, everything should be working absolutely finesse. They are the mod author's words. They should be working absolutely fine. Mine worked pretty cool too. This one can be crafted at the Skyforge. Pretty much pick two of these little blades up. I personally really do like the textures on these two particular blades. They look very, very creepy. Obviously, they are going to be vanilla blades, but just the textures for me definitely win this over as a mod as a whole. Very enjoyable. Again, a little bit more poison damage. Not too sure if these are upgradable via the grindstone. If you can do that, it's going to be in the video. If not, let me know down in the comment section below. So guys, that's the end of this video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. This has been episode 422 within my series. God, that is an awful lot when you actually think about it. There's a ton of episodes for you guys to indulge. If you haven't checked out any of the other ones, have a little look at them. You might grab something that you think, wow, it's a little bit of older mod. But who knows, something might resurface that you really could enjoy. But guys, if you did enjoy the video as a whole, click that subscribe button. Obviously, click that little bell right next to it to get a notification for every single time I post a bit of content to the channel. But until the next one, guys, get a kefir and get a kef out.